good morning, and surprise. Got a call earlier this week that there was a possibility of some grandchildren of Pastor Bill and Rhonda might have the virus, and therefore he said, could you do the service next Sunday and do the taping? And I said, sure. So, surprise, I'm back. We welcome you this morning in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. The Wednesday night service went fairly well this past week, and so we'll be doing it again this coming week, 7 o'clock on Wednesday. I invite you to come. If you can come, please call ahead so that we can make sure that there will be room, because there's only a certain amount of people that we can get into the parking lot. So please call if you would like to come for that. Julie, would you lead us in our opening music? Let us confess our sins this morning, and then have God's forgiveness for us. Let us pray. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who forgives us all of our sin, and whose mercy endures forever. Amen. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom those secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Gracious God, have mercy on us. We confess that we have turned from you and given ourselves into the power of sin. We are truly sorry and humbly repent. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things we have done and things we have failed to do. Turn us again to you, and uphold us by your Spirit, so that we may live and serve you in newness of life, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. God, who is rich in mercy, loved us even when we were dead in sin, and made us alive together with Christ. By grace we have been saved, In the name of Jesus Christ, our sins are forgiven. Almighty God, strengthen us with power through the Holy Spirit, that Christ may live in our hearts through faith. Amen. We sing our opening hymn, Blessed Assurance, hymn 638. Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Here he is.
He lays on pray. God of grace, you have given us minds to know you, hearts to love you, and voices to sing your praise. Fill us with your Spirit, that we may celebrate your glory and worship you in spirit and in truth. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Let us pray together the prayer of the day. Merciful God, most merciful Judge, you care for your children with firmness and compassion. By your Spirit, nurture us who live in your kingdom, that we may be rooted in the way of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. For the sharing of the peace this morning, let us do it with our peace hug. Amen.
The first reading for this 19th day of July is from Isaiah 44, verses 6 through 8. There are no other gods besides God. The word of the Lord does not fail to come to pass. We can trust in God, through whom Israel and we are redeemed. Thus says the Lord, the King of Israel, and his Redeemer, the Lord of hosts. I am the first, and I am the last. Besides me, there is no God. Who is like me? Let them proclaim it. Let them declare it and set it forth before me. Who has announced from of old the things to come? Let them tell us what it is yet to be. Do not fear or be afraid. Have I not told you from of old and declared it? You are my witnesses. Is there any God besides me? There is no other rock. I know not one. The psalm for this 19th of July, Psalm 86, verses 11 through 17. Teach me your way, O Lord, and I will walk in your truth. Give me an undivided heart to revere your name. I will thank you, O Lord my God, with all my heart, and glorify your name forevermore. For great is your love toward me. You have delivered me from the pit of death. The arrogant rise up against me, O God, and a band of violent people seeks my life. They have not set you before their eyes. But you, O Lord, are gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger, and full of kindness and truth. Turn to me and have mercy on me. Give your strength to your servant, and save the child of your handmaid. Show me a sign of your favor, so that those who hate me may see it and be put to shame, because you, Lord, have helped me and comforted me. The second reading for this Sunday is from Romans chapter 8, verses 12 through 25. For Paul, true superiority means that we experience the reality of the Spirit, which enables us to pray as God's children, keeps us in solidarity with creation, and gives us unseen hope that God will liberate us and creation from bondage to death and decay. So then, brothers and sisters, we are debtors not to the flesh, to live according to the flesh. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the deeds of the body, you will live. For all who are led by the Spirit of God are children of God. For you did not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you have received a spirit of adoption. When we cry, Abba, Father, it is that very Spirit bearing witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ, if, in fact, we suffer with him, so that we may also be glorified with him. I consider that the sufferings of this present time are not worth comparing with the glory about to be revealed to us. For the creation waits with eager longing for the revealing of the children of God. For the creation was subjected to futility, not of its own will, but the will of the one who subjected it, in hope that the creation itself will be set free from its bondage to decay and will obtain the freedom of the glory of the children of God. We know that the whole creation has been groaning in labor pains until now. And not only the creation, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit, groan inwardly while we wait adoption, the redemption of our bodies. For in hope we were saved. Now hope that is seen is not hope. For who hopes for what is seen? But if we hope for what we do not see, we wait for it with patience. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
According to Matthew 13, verses 24 through 30 and 36 through 43. Glory to you, O Lord. And Jesus put before the crowds another parable. The kingdom of heaven may be compared to one who sows good seed in his field. But while everyone is asleep, an enemy came and sowed weeds among the wheat and then went away. So when the plants came up and bore grain, then the weeds appeared also. And the slaves of the householder came and said to him, Master, did you not sow good seed in your field? Where then did these weeds come from? And the master answered, An enemy has done this. And the slave said to him, Then do you want us to go and gather them? But the master replied, No, for in gathering the weeds, you would uproot the wheat also along with them. Let both of them grow together until the harvest. At the harvest time, I will tell the reapers, collect the weeds first and bind them in bundles to be burned, but then gather the wheat into my barn. Then he left the crowds and went into the house where he was staying. His disciples approached him, saying, "Master, please explain to us this parable of the weeds of the field." And Jesus answered, "The one who sows good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world. The good seed are the children of the kingdom. The weeds are the children of the evil one. The enemy who sowed them is the devil. The harvest is at the end of the age, and the reapers are the angels. Just as the weeds are collected and burned up with fire, so it will be at the end of the age. The Son of Man will send his angels, and they will collect out of his kingdom all causes of sin and evildoers. And then they will turn them into the furnace of fire, and there they will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. But then the righteous will shine like the sun in the kingdom of their Father. So let everyone who has ears listen." This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Good morning, children of God. We heard that this morning in our lessons, how Paul calls us to be the children of God. As I thought about that, I thought about our money, be it as bills or our coins. There's a good phrase that's put on that. In God we trust. In God we trust. Not in money, not in things, but that we should be reminded as we use our money to say, in God we trust. We put our trust in God because we know that He loves us. He cares about us. And one of the greatest verses in the Bible, he says, "In God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son to die for us, that we might have eternal life." And so, as children of God, we should do what our money says we should do, be it the paper ones or the coins, but that we should trust in our God. Let us pray. Good morning, Lord. We thank you that you are our God. And Lord, in the midst of all the troubles that we might have, all the challenges that we might have, we pray that you would help us. Help us to put our hand in yours, to trust in you. For as we trust in you, as we obey your word, then things work out so much better. Help us, Lord. For it's in your name that we pray. Amen. Let us pray. O Lord, bless us as we gather this morning, as we hear your word. Give us ears to listen, eyes to see, hearts to believe, and a will to follow your commands. Yes, Lord, may the words of our mouths, the meditation of our hearts, and the way we live be found acceptable in your sight, O Lord. For you are our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. People loved of God, because that's who we are. How are we doing? I don't know about you, but there are sure times when lately I've needed help. Help because we've lost normal. Or maybe we'd have to say just what is normal. Maybe we have to honestly ask ourselves, how is our faith? Because when we can't come together as people of God for worship, even as some of us gather during the week to tape this. It's just not the same. How is our faith? As Paul wrote to that church in Rome that we heard this morning, that Vern read, are we of the flesh or are we of the spirit? Are we struggling in this day and age today, even being Christians? As I looked at the lessons for this week, I found myself going back to some legal events that happen in our lives, some legal statements, some legal occurrences. When maybe we hear the words, will you please tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth? Yeah. Have we forgotten what the truth is all about? Have we forgotten, as I said in the children's sermon, do we really trust in God? Do we really feel that we are one nation under God? Or have we forgotten in this pandemic? Pandemic of the virus, but maybe a pandemic of sin and of the flesh also. Do we find ourselves saying, as Pilate did when Jesus was being tried, what is truth? Well, thanks be to God, we've got some good verses before us this morning. We've got some good scripture lessons that God is truth, that He is the way, the truth, and the life. And He invites us to know God and to say, God, yes, you are truth, that you are alive and you live in us. You are the first and the last. You are that Alpha and that Omega, the beginning and the end. You are everything between A and Z. God, you are present. Even as we struggle, that you are with us. That you see us, you know us, you forgive us, and you renew us. That as we trust in God who is true, there is no falseness in God. God is not fake news. There is no weakness in God. Have you witnessed the presence of God? Have you witnessed the love, the caring of God? That as we confess our faith and our creed, I believe in God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, do we really mean that? So that our faith is strong. That our faith is not shaken. That there is a normality there. The other verse, or the other thing that I found that goes back to legal events and occurrences, is a word that Paul used this morning, that we are adopted children of God. I thought back to when Carolyn and I adopted our two boys. There was all kinds of paper that we had to fill out. There was all kinds of things that we had to sign. There was money that was exchanged as we paid for a consular ad litem. There were calls that were made between us and attorneys, us and Lutheran World or Lutheran Social Service. We had to wait 6 months. Some people even say adoption takes 9 months, once the child even comes. Do we really want that child to be our child? We had 6 months to make that decision. The state had a chance to look and say, do we really want to give Mike and Steve, these two boys, to Roger and Carolyn? And we passed. But when God adopts us, when God adopted you and me in our baptisms, there was no papers that had to be filled out. There was no money that was exchanged. There was no waiting period. It happened, bam, just like that. We are children of God from our baptism onward. Because we've got a God who cares, who protects, preserves, and provides for us. A God who says, I am God, there is no other. When I got a call from Pastor Bill this week to see if I would do this week, I asked him, I said, well, have you got hymns picked out? Or do I get to pick out my own hymns so that they apply to what I want to say? And Bill says, I've already picked them out. Check them out and see if you want them. I didn't change a word. I didn't change one hymn that he had selected. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. As we'll close our worship this morning, how great thou art. There's the truth that will make us free. God, help us as people of God, as children of God, to have hearts that are not divided between this world and God. Create in us clean hearts, O God, pure hearts. The hearts that are completely for you, that we love you with all of our hearts, all of our minds, and all of our spirits. And the psalmist said, God, show us a sign. Show us a sign that we'll know that you are truth, that you are God. And he has, hasn't he, in our baptism. As we come for communion, as we gather together as people of God, as Jesus says, I'm the light, but you're a light also. That light that we heard about when we were baptized, that we hear when other people are baptized. Let your light so shine before all people that they will see in your life good things, and they'll glorify your Father who is in heaven. The whole truth. God loves us. God cares about us. Even as we struggle with this virus, even as we continue to struggle in sin. That we're not of the flesh. We're of the Spirit. The Spirit who calls us by the gospel, who enlightens us with his gifts of communion and the Word of God, who gathers us together as people of God, who keeps us in that true faith. May God be praised. Amen. Our hymn of the day today is On Eagle's Wings, hymn number 787. us confess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Our prayer song for our prayers of intercession this week is Jesus, Keep Me Near the Cross. We will sing the first verse, and then we'll have prayers. I invite you to join in those prayers, and then we will sing again the first verse of Jesus, Keep Me Near the Cross. Jesus, keep me near the cross, where the precious fountain, free to all the healing stream, flows from Calvary's mountain. God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, you claim and you are the way, the truth, and the life. You are the first and the last, the Alpha, the Omega. You provide, you protect, and you preserve us. Lord, help us to know and to believe that you do care, for you have created us, you redeem us, and you sanctify us. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Oh Lord, we thank you for our baptism. We thank you that we can gather for worship, to hear your word, to come to realize and to know that we are children of God. So Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, please help us and strengthen us. We pray for our pastor and for his wife, Rhonda. We pray for our families, our individual families and our church family. We pray for our neighbors. We pray for our community, for our state and nation and world. Come and bring your healing presence over the pandemic, over the power of sin, and make us whole. O Lord, help us not to be divided in our faith, but help us to realize that by your Spirit, you call us, you enlighten us, you keep us, and you gather us together as a people of God. Lord, we thank you for the opportunity that you give to us to gather together, to realize that you care. Help us to care for one another. Help us to have concerns for one another. And Lord, help us to live in your truth, your whole truth and nothing but the truth. Help us to trust, to be and to realize that we are a people of God, that we are your children, that we are your light, For Lord, we are one, children of God. So hear our prayers, and answer our prayers according to your wisdom. For it's in your Son's name that we do pray. Amen. Present our offerings this morning. We give you thanks for helping us during this time of pandemic as you bring your gifts, that all of God's work here and throughout the world can be done.
I lay my sins on Jesus, the spotless Lamb of God. He bears them all and frees us from the accursed load. I bring my guilt to Jesus, to wash my crimson stains, white in his blood most precious, till not a spot remains. I lay my wants on Jesus, all fullness dwells in him. He heals all my diseases, he doth my soul redeem. I lay my griefs on Jesus, my burdens and my cares. He from them all releases, he all my sorrow shares. I long to be like Jesus, meek, loving, lowly, mild. I long to be like Jesus, the Father's holy child. I long to be with Jesus amid the heavenly throng, to sing with saints his praises, to learn the angel's song. I lay my sins on
Let us pray our offering prayer. God of all creation, all you have made is good, and your love endures forever. You bring forth bread from the earth and fruit from the vine. Nourish us with these gifts, that we might be for the world signs of your gracious presence. In Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. We pray to our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Our sending hymn is How Great Thou Art, hymn 856.
Thank you. lift up his face to shine on you.
As we go in peace and serve the Lord, I also want to share with you, I forgot to do that during the service, so I'm adding it here at the end, that Bill and Rhonda, Pastor Bill, they've given us the wonderful good news that both of their grandkids, they're negative for the virus. And so we praise God for that, and Pastor Bill will be back. Amen.